Hi, I'm Laura Wilson from La Dolce Vita. So we've pulled our cookies out of the oven and we've let them cool completely. And here they are. And if you can see, here are some of the little air holes that they've made by the cold butter hitting the hot oven. You see, that makes them really flaky like that. And that's all the way through the cookie. So when you bite into the cookie, we'll go with the wing here. I don't know if you can see how flaky it is. It's so flaky and tender. That's what you want. That's what we're aiming for. Now we're going to make the royal icing. There's a couple different recipes. I like Martha Stewart's recipe, and I happen to like the one that uses real egg whites. She also has one that uses meringue powder. You can buy this meringue powder at most grocery stores. I know you can buy it at Fresh Market. I think you can buy it at Meijer too. I'm not sure about Kroger. But you can definitely buy this at Country Kitchen if you want to go there and get it. So people that are worried about raw egg whites can do this. But our eggs are pasteurized. I'm not very worried about that. Okay, so I use 4 cups. This is a great thing to buy too, which is a 2-cup measurer of powdered sugar. And this recipe calls for just a little bit, 1/2 teaspoon of cream of tartar. It's interesting, my favorite chef in France will not eat cream of tartar because a cream of tartar, I guess, is from a mineral. And I don't know which one. And he says, well, I will not put that in my body. So if a recipe calls for cream of tartar, he leaves it. But you can't really make a snickerdoodle without cream of tartar, and you won't get that really great taste. So, however, they don't eat those over there. Now we're going to crack a couple eggs because we need 5 tablespoons of egg whites. So we're cracking them and we're separating the eggs. Some people separate it by running it through their fingers. I have broken a lot of egg whites by that. I must just want to squeeze my hand down. So there's one. Yeah, that'll be enough. An egg white weighs 30 grams and an egg yolk weighs 20, just if you want to know that for a Trivial Pursuit game. Also, if you drop a piece of eggshell in, I did write about this before, the best way to get it out is not to use a spoon to fish it out, but to actually use your shell, because it seems to have a magnetism, like attracts like, and that's what picks it up the very best. So find a shell that's not real crumbly on the end. So, all right, we've got 2 eggs in here. We need 5 teaspoons of egg white. So, whoa, they are slippery little guys. There's one. Gotta do it fast. 2, 3, 4. Ooh, they're sliding out. I'm gonna use it all. We're gonna say 2 egg whites or 5 tablespoons. I think that's about right. And now we're just gonna mix it up with a mixer. You could mix it up by hand if you want. It's really thick. Now if you wanna thin this down a little bit, you can use water, but I like to use a flavoring like orange or lemon because your cookie doesn't have any flavor except it's a butter cookie. So normally I would just put this over a little strainer so I don't get it. This isn't very seedy, this lemon, so that's good. Orange is good, lemon. One of those little kiwis, little tangerines. I'll do it just a smidge more. So this is thick. All right, I've used 1/2 lemon and 2 egg whites. And as you see, it's very thick. This is a good thickness to use to make your dam around the end or your border. So take These are bags that you get at Meijer. I really don't like them. They're from Wilton. They're hard to hold on to. They don't twist well. These you can get at Country Kitchen. They come in all different sizes, and they come in on a long sheet, and you just tear what you need. And there's your tip. You can buy these little tips. You know, I'm not loving these tiny tips because they're so little. I'm used to bigger tips. So you can go online and go to macfur.com and get big bags if you're gonna do some curd or something that you wanna pipe out. And they have bigger tips that are nice. But today, we're going to use this tip. This is a small tip of what's the number on it? I can't read it. So what you want to do is put your tip in and stuff your bag in. Then you can cut the end of your tip off. Before you stuff, make sure it goes through. I'm gonna cut a little more. I'll get rid of that because that's gonna get in your cookies. There. Now, stuff your bag in. Turn your bag over. We're just gonna put it in the bag. Some people like to use the squirt bottles, and that's a good thing to use too. Yeah, this is really thick. This might just be just a little too thick. So I'm just gonna put in a little bit because the rest we're gonna thin down. And now I might need a smidge more. Push it down, and it's going to naturally open up. You can pull that bag up. The reason you stuff it is so it doesn't fall out if it's really liquidy. And now we're going to pipe it. So what we want to do is go around the border. And make a dam, which we will flood the next part. And then the dam will keep it from falling off the cookie. Yeah, I kind of messed up right there. There. Let's do another one. But do follow the angle of your cookie, like I kind of went up for his little head. All right, so we'll just do those. Now we have this thick royal icing. We want to thin it down because we're going to flood the cookie. But keep this icing. Now, what you want to do is you just wrap the tip in a wet paper towel and set it aside. Just put a wet paper towel over it so your tip doesn't dry off and you get a little hard part in it. All right, we're going to add a little water. And we're just going to go super gently, maybe a tablespoon at a time. And when we get it the consistency that we want, then we'll add the color. This is about right because, as you see, it's going down the side of my pan. So I might just make it, put a half a tablespoon more in, or maybe just a teaspoon more. But how about that? That's tablespoon is 3 teaspoons. So we'll just make it a little. Color is by putting in with a toothpick, because these new colors are super concentrated. What you get at the grocery isn't so concentrated, but if you get a box of it, it's super concentrated. So if you want a really light spring pink, you're going to want to add it with, even though this says soft pink, you're going to want to add it with that, because you know when you're adding that, it can really get a big drop of it. So I added that's just one dip of the toothpick, and see how concentrated it is. That's really pretty. That's very springy, because we're doing Easter cookies. There. And try to mix it all in so you don't get streaks. And of course, if you were doing lots of cookies, you would divide this up and you'd have yellow and, you know, all the colors that you love in here. Now, keep your toothpicks handy, because the toothpick's going to be a super great friend for you. Now we're going to add this on like this. We're going to give it a droplet. We're going to kind of, we might need to bring the toothpick now. We're going to use a toothpick to move it. Why are we using a toothpick? Well, you want to get right up. You want to get right up to your border, and if you use a knife, often you can smash your border, because knife is a little clumsy when it comes to this fine work. So if you have a cookie that is like an egg, you can definitely pour it around. But here, this has all these shapes, so we're gonna use this. It even looks like I could have added 2 teaspoons more. So a tablespoon of water and 2 teaspoons probably would have been maybe even better. Letting gravity do some of it, you know. I do have a little teeny tiny spatula that I could use in the middle parts. These are great. They're a bit not expensive, and they come in handy for a myriad of things in your kitchen. So maybe it'd be a good time to get one. And I need a little more icing. So ice cookies are a labor of love. And when people just shove them in their mouth, they don't know how much work goes into them. And I have a friend, and she makes the most beautiful cookies, and they are, she just labors over them, writes messages on them. They're gorgeous. It's kind of an artwork. Maybe it's not my strongest suit, because I run out of patience after a while, but I sure make a lot of them. All right, so that's good. I'm just going to finish it all up to the edges. Come on, get up there. And if you have some peaks and valleys, usually that'll dry and now, some people like to pipe another border on top of that, just to give it a really finished look. Another border on top of its original border. So I'm going to do that, just for those times that I iced over the border. A mistake there. So see if I can pull this back. Oh, yes. Nice. Can you see what I did? I got out and I just pulled it back. There. So any place where you kind of come away, you could make that a little thicker. I have two places like that. Now just take your finger and go around any little spots, smooth them down. All right, so now you could make designs. You could make, if it's an egg, you can make squiggles, whatever. A lot of people love this beautiful sanding sugar that they have. It's so delicate, it almost looks like, I don't know, fairy dust or something. This is sugar crystals. These are sugar crystals. These are nice. Let's see if I have any. This is sanding sugar, white sanding sugar, which is really pretty. So I just, either I push the thing back and pour it, or I take my fingers and I just go over like that. And it looks like dew on the flower. So there's one cookie done. Look at many tutorials online, but this is kind of how they teach at Country Kitchen to do a double border. Martha Stewart does a single border. I do whatever I think looks the best at that time. So thank you so much. Bye-bye.